Well, Matt.
Yep.
It's 2020.
Yep. New year.
I'm hungry.
Same here.
What should we eat?
Well, we've done chicken nuggets, fries.
We did fries. We did chicken sandwiches.
Yeah, chicken sandwiches too.
What else have we done?
Cheeseburgers.
Cheese. Cheese.
Ooey gooey cheese.
I have it. I know what we need to do.
What is it?
You know what we need to find? It's time to find out who the real Mac Daddy is.
Oh yeah.
Hello everybody, welcome to a brand new episode of Fast Food Throwdown. This is your favorite show where we go to a bunch of fast food places and
try out their food
and find out who has the best among various fast food locations. My name is Chris. I'm joined by Matt, my co-host. Today we are going to be doing the Mac and Cheese Mac Daddy Challenge. So essentially we're going to go to six different fast food locations that serve mac and cheese as a side, which I bet you didn't know six different places serve mac and cheese.
I'm sure there's more, but we only picked six.
These are the ones that we figured out. We're going to try the mac and cheese. We are going to grade it, and then we're going to rank all six locations. So, you ready for some mac and cheese deliciousness?
Oh, I'm ready for some gooey gooey cheesy.
Okay. Well, before then, a little criteria. The main things we're looking for in a good mac and cheese has to have good flavor.
Right.
And it has to have a good consistency. So it has to be cheesy. It has to have a nice, bold cheese flavor.
Oh, yeah, but a good noodle quality, too.
Yeah, you don't want crap noodles.
Yeah.
Undercooked, overcooked, you don't want any of that.
Yeah.
Has to be perfectly cooked noodles. All right. Ready to get some cheese?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right, our first location is going to be Panera Bread. Get some mac and cheese from the bread place. Let's go. All right, we're at our first place, Panera. We're gonna do two separate orders. Is that okay?
So two separate payments?
Yes.
Yeah,
okay. First one is gonna be a small mac and cheese, and that's it. And then yours?
I'm also gonna do a small mac and cheese as well. That's it.
All right, sounds good. Thank you. All right, well, we're getting some mac and cheese from Panera, so should be good. All right, so we have our first thing, which is our side of Panera mac and cheese. So this was $5, no, almost $6.
Yeah, with the tax, almost $6.
A little pricey. We don't normally talk about prices on this show, but we might as well this time.
Yeah.
Because mac and cheese is a pretty cheap food item.
So usually it is.
Usually. So this was $5. So it better be good. This appears to be, is it shells?
Yes, shells.
Shells. It smells very creamy.
It smells very good, yeah.
All right, so here's a close-up of the ooey-gooiness. Ooh. Oh, you dropped some.
Yeah.
It looks good. It looks really good. Ready?
Sure.
Bottoms up. Very creamy.
Mm-hmm.
Very milky. The cheese is there. It's not a super bold cheese.
Yeah, it's
very mellow.
Yeah, very mellow flavors. Nice on the shell noodles, but
it's cooked well. I don't think it's bold enough. I think it needs to be bolder. So
yeah,
good attempt, Panera. We'll see how it compares to the rest of the mac and cheeses. I don't know how well. So
yeah, we still got 5 more places to stop by.
Yeah, we got a long way to go. All right, our next location is Arby's, who has a brand new mac and cheese that they have debuted. It's white cheddar. Excited to try it. This challenge.
We're actually gonna have two separate orders. Is that okay?
Yeah, you can have that first one whenever you're ready.
All right, I'm gonna do a mac and cheese, and that's it.
The total for that first one is gonna be $3.22. You can have that second one whenever you're ready.
Okay.
It's also gonna be just a side of mac and cheese.
Just a side of mac and cheese. Alrighty. And it's gonna be $3.32 for that one. So whenever you're ready.
Thank you. All right, time to get some Arby's mac and cheese. All right, so we just got back of Arby's, and as you can see, it's kind of late, so the lighting is going to be a little inconsistent, so I apologize for that, but, you know, it is what it is. This is our Arby's mac and cheese. Now, one thing that I noticed that's interesting, this is basically the same size as the Panera one.
True, but it's a lot cheaper.
This was, like, $3.21, so a lot cheaper than Panera. Both Matt and I have had this. We liked it a lot. Let's see how it compares. Bottoms up.
They wanted the traditional elbow noodles in this one.
They did. The main thing I like about this is the cheese.
You get the white cheddar white away.
It's a very distinct flavor. It's very creamy. It's very bold. Kind of what you would expect from Arby's.
And definitely has a unique aftertaste too, though.
It's a good aftertaste, though. Like, I actually like it. So, well done, Arby's.
Performance.
Very strong performance from Arby's for another delicious mac and cheese. All right, onward to the next location. All right, location number three, KFC. Going to see the Colonel, try his classic mac and cheese.
All right, we're gonna do two separate orders, okay?
Okay, go ahead with the first.
All right, I'm gonna do a side of mac and cheese, a small. And a large Mountain Dew Sweet Lightning.
Okay.
And that'll do.
$4.93 for that one.
Okay.
All right, for the second one, I'm going to do a $5 Famous Bowl original. Can I get the drink large with a strawberry lemonade? And then an individual mac and cheese.
Okay.
$7.31
for that one.
All right. We got our mac and cheese. Let's, and drinks, because we needed drinks.
Oh, yeah.
Let's try it out. All right, so now we have KFC mac and cheese. It's pretty classic. I mean, oftentimes if you go to KFC, you got to get the mac and cheese as a side. So.
True.
All right, let's dig in. Let's try a nice spoonful of this. Bottoms up. Very mushy.
Very mushy. Got the usual elbow noodles, but not too much taste to them.
No, this is serviceable mac and cheese. Definitely not. And like, if you're having mac
it's
and cheese,
it's almost like high school mac and cheese.
Yeah, like in terms of just being a simple side dish, it's not terrible. But if you're looking to have mac and cheese, this ain't it.
Yeah, if you want the Mac Daddy experience, this wouldn't be the one.
I can tell you right now, KFC is not going to be the Mac Daddy. That is for sure. All right, we also got drinks because we needed them.
All this cheese makes you thirsty.
It really does. All right. Onward to our next destination. Let's go. All right. You know we had to do it. It's time to go to Chick-fil-A for some mac and cheese. We had it last time. It was amazing. I'm excited to have some more.
Let's go. Chick-fil-A. My name's Evelyn. How may I serve you?
Hi. I have a mobile order for Chris.
All right. It'll be a pleasure to serve you at the window, Chris.
Okay. We have a second order as well.
You have a second order as well? What
yes.
Would you like?
An individual side of mac and cheese, that's it.
Just a side of mac and cheese?
Yes.
All right. It'll be $3.54 for that mac and cheese at the window.
All right, thank you.
My pleasure.
All right. Chick-fil-A is always so nice. They always are.
They have the Southern hospitality.
They really do. All right, well, let's get some Chick-fil-A mac and cheese. Okay, so we have gone to Chick-fil-A. We've gotten some delicious mac and cheese. Chick-fil-A mac and cheese, we know is good. It's baked mac and cheese.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Ooh, look at that cheese.
That cheese pull. That's one of the signs of good mac and cheese is when you have your cheese pull. Bottoms up.
Mm. Even though the traditional elbow noodles, like the cheese just has a very distinct flavor with the mac and cheese.
It's bold. You can tell it's got that baked because it's got like big pieces of cheese in it. And again, the big thing is the cheese pull. Like when you lift that piece up, you see that stretch of cheese. That just tells you this is made of genuine, really good cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Chick-fil-A mac and cheese
is
awesome.
It's up there.
But I decided, you know what? We're having a lot of mac and cheese. I want to do a little experiment. I'm going to see how Chick-fil-A mac and cheese is going to be on top of a Chick-fil-A spicy chicken sandwich. Probably pretty good, I would imagine. So this is what my Mac-ified spicy chicken sandwich is gonna look like. Let's try this out. Bottoms up. That's really good. As you would expect, cheese just adds that really nice creamy texture and extra flavor to the already delicious spicy chicken. Potentially two grand champions right here in one sandwich. Okay, Matt, you've had four.
Let's go to the next one.
Let's go to the next one.
All right, we've officially gotten out of the car to try our next fast food throwdown location, Wawa. Now, if you don't know what Wawa is, it's a gas station, but it's a much better gas station. They serve some really good food. Oh, it's a significantly better 7-Eleven. So we actually have to go in to order our mac and cheese, but we're going to get it, and we'll share our thoughts.
All right, so this is our Wawa mac and cheese. It looks very similar to KFC. Maybe a little better quality, but let's see if it tastes better. Bottoms up. It's blander.
Yeah, I honestly think this might actually be worse than KFC, to be honest.
I think it is, because KFC has more flavor. This just tastes like nothing.
Yeah, even the noodle is like,
it's
almost
limp.
A little overdone, I think.
I do get that sharp cheddar flavor a little bit. It's almost too sharp, though. Like, you need
like
to
I
be...
Said, it's just like the KFC...
You need there to be kind of a mix of creamy, but have that bold flavor. This is, the flavor's almost non-existent.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had straight up Wawa mac and cheese, and now I see why.
Yeah.
It's pretty disappointing. So, all right, well, we're down to two. Yes, I said two because we forgot one. We added an additional contender to the list. So two more places to go, and then we'll have our definitive ranking.
Let's go.
Let's go. Again, sorry about the lighting. Hi, we'd like to do two separate orders, if that's okay.
All right, go ahead and get the first one.
Can I get the side item sampler, but of just mac and cheese? And that's it for the first one.
The first one? All right. All right, well, the second one?
Just a regular side of mac and cheese, please.
That's the second order?
Yes.
That'd be awesome.
That's it.
All right, so for around the window, for a cool piece.
Thank you. All right. Well, they are open, thankfully. So we were worried they weren't going to be. So let's get some Boston Market. So Matt did the sensible thing and got a side of mac and cheese.
Chris had to go overboard and get a whole plate of just mac and cheese.
I got the side sampler of just mac and cheese, which is very foolish of me. But you know what? I really like this mac and cheese.
So do I, but I still did the sensible thing.
You did. Let's be honest. Okay. So this is the Boston Market mac and cheese. Now, this one, the main thing that's different is it's spiral noodles. And it's the only place that does spiral noodles.
True.
Let's try it.
Mmm. So chewy and so creamy.
It's got really good flavor.
It really does.
It's good
flavor. Boston Market knows their mac and cheese very well.
I think the biggest strong suit of this one is the spiral noodles. Because it gives it a different texture than what you're used to with mac and cheese. Usually just kind of mushy. This one is a little bit different.
Yeah, that spiral just adds the unique texture to the mac and cheese. That makes it one of the top mac and cheese contenders, in both of our opinions.
Really good mac and cheese. All right, we have one more...
surprise guest to do.
One more surprise place to go. And then we are going to give you our definitive... Mac Daddy Mac and Cheese Championship. So let's head to our final destination.
Find out soon.
And see what the best mac and cheese available from fast food locations is.
Last place is Firehouse Subs, because apparently they have mac and cheese. So we're going to try some Firehouse Subs mac and cheese.
All right, so this is the Firehouse Subs 5 cheese mac and cheese. So we're going to try straight up, and then we're going to add these breadcrumbs that were supplied to us and see how it tastes. This is a very soupy one. Bottoms up.
Not bad.
It tastes a lot like Kraft. Not in a bad way, but it reminds me a lot of like a Kraft mac and cheese, like something you can make at home. It's not bad. All right, now we're gonna add the breadcrumbs and see if the breadcrumbs make a big difference. I doubt it, but you never know.
Adds a nice crunch.
The smell of the breadcrumbs actually changes it up quite a bit.
gives it a nice texture.
Actually, yeah. The breadcrumbs make it very Italian tasting. We have tried
seven
different Macs.
Time to find the Mac Daddy.
So we have a few that we need to retry. Once we do that, we're going to give you our final ranking for who is
the Mac Daddy of mac and cheese.
Fast food mac and cheese.
Okay. We have returned from our mac and cheese quest.
Yes, we have.
And I think it is time to reveal the final results. So what Matt and I did, we actually consulted each other for the bottom four.
And we have the same bottom four throughout the list.
We're going to chime in on some brief thoughts on each one. But the top three, we don't know. We don't know what each other ranked. So it'll be interesting to see what the results are.
Yeah.
All right. So we'll start off with the bottom, the worst of the fast food mac and cheese, Wawa. Why Wawa?
It's actually very bland. It's even worse than high school mac and cheese.
Like, that's the thing that surprised me, is Wawa normally has incredibly high quality food. The mac and cheese, now granted, Wawa has a bunch of different things you can mix into the mac and cheese. So maybe it's intended to be kind of bland on its own because you're supposed to mix in other stuff with it. And I get that, but on its own, it's not good. It's very bland.
It's even worse than the number six spot, thought was going to be the last.
It has the same consistency as KFC, but it's just worse in every way. So we're really disappointed by Wawa.
Mm-hmm.
All right, number six is KFC, which I expected to be last, like Matt said. And honestly, it has more flavor than Wawa, as shocking as that is.
It's just like high school mac and cheese that you get if you went to public schools.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, as a side dish, it's serviceable. Like, it's not bad, but if you're just eating it as a side, it's fine. It'll get the job done. But on its own, it's not very good.
No.
It's pretty bland, to be honest. And the consistency's not good on that one.
Mm-hmm.
All right, number five is going to be Panera. Now, this one might shock a lot of people just because Panera, typically, people love Panera.
Food.
And I felt the noodles were good. This is the only one that had shell noodles.
Right.
But it was bland.
The cheese was too creamy.
It was too creamy and just was bland. It doesn't have a strong flavor.
Especially for the price that they offer, too.
Yeah, it was also the most expensive on its own of the mac and cheeses that we got. And the price tag did not match quality, to be honest. So that was number five. Number four is going to be Firehouse. So I was surprised by that one. It was funny because when we actually ordered it, the employees were like, oh yeah, ours is better than all those other ones. It was better than a lot of them, but it was not better than our top three. It was better than I expected, honestly. I did not expect a whole lot from Firehouse, but it was good. It was creamy. And when you added those breadcrumbs, or granted, breadcrumbs were supplemental, it also added more flavor. It added kind of an Italian vibe to it.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't bad.
Right.
It was pretty good. It was better than the bottom three, but it's not as good as the top three. Okay, let's get to the big ones.
Uh-huh.
So we're going to go line by line. I'm going to say my third place. You're going to say yours, and we'll say why we picked them.
Okay.
So for me, number three is going to Boston Market. Now, this shocks me, honestly. When I started this whole thing, I fully expected Boston Market to be the number one. I love Boston Market mac and cheese. It's really good. However, even though the noodles, I feel, are the strongest of all of the mac and cheeses, the cheese flavor, it's good, but it's not as bold as the top two on my list. I like it. I don't love it as much as the others. Matt, what was your number three?
Like Chris said, I thought Boston Market was going to be number one. Unfortunately, my number three, I have to go to Arby's just because, while, yes, the mac and cheese is a little bit strong with the gooiness, I just feel the cheese kind of almost overpowers the noodles in the mac and cheese.
That's an interesting take. So going to number two, my number two is actually Arby's. And that one also surprised me a lot because Arby's is the newest game. Like, out of all these places, Arby's is only serving mac and cheese as a limited time thing.
They just started it, too.
They just started it. Really good. It's a white cheddar mac. It has a nice punch of white cheddar flavor. You thought it was a little overpowering. It's an assertive flavor, that is for sure, but I think that really enhances it. The texture was right. It tastes much more like a home-style mac and cheese, which I appreciate. And the value was good. It's like $3, oh, yeah. And you get a basically the same amount as you did for Panera.
Pretty much, yeah.
I liked it. I put it at number two. What was your number two, Matt?
Boston Market. Spiral noodles, they just edged out the elbow noodles of the Arby's. And the, well, like I said, the cheese sauce for the Boston Market is very good. It just couldn't beat number one.
And that means we have a consistent number one.
Chick-fil-A
with its third grand champion of Fast Food Throwdown. We have now done five of these. Chick-fil-A has won three different ones for best sauce, best specialty sauce, best chicken sandwich, and now best mac and cheese. The Chick-fil-A mac and cheese, it just has the same amount of quality as you would expect from Chick-fil-A. It's baked mac and cheese.
Which is why it went number one.
It has that cheese pull, which none of the other mac and cheeses we tried had that cheese pull. Most were kind of just soupy-ish. This one was not. You pull it up. Arby's almost had it.
Yeah, it was almost... Arby's almost had it, but it was just... It still had a little bit too much creamy to it.
But the ratio is perfect on the Chick-fil-A mac and cheese. You've got those big pieces of cheese that just string out. The cheese flavor is perfect. The noodles are cooked excellently. It's an amazing value for how much you paid. Yeah. You paid $3?
Pretty much.
For a pretty good side of mac and cheese. And you can get it with your meal too, which is pretty amazing. So
you can substitute those waffle fries for the mac and cheese if you want.
Which you should. And especially if you get a spicy chicken sandwich, you should put some of that mac and cheese on said chicken sandwich because it's really good. So, there you go. We tried seven different fast food mac and cheeses, and we determined
Chick-fil-A is the Mac Daddy.
Chick-fil-A is the Mac Daddy of fast food mac and cheese. Thank you for watching this brand new episode of Fast Food Throwdown. We are not done. We still have several more. We've actually been brainstorming during this one what we're going to do next. We have a lot of options, and we're going to do more throughout the course of the year. So, Fast Food Throwdown is going to continue, and I'm sure we're going to have some awesome new episodes. So,
stay tuned for more.
Yes. Matt, thank you for joining me once again.
No problem.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you for watching Fast Food Throwdown. Please hit that subscribe button if you have not done so already. Hit that notification bell. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at BigCTVShow. And we'll see you on the next Fast Food Throwdown.
Bye.